On January 15th, 2022, the Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano in the nation of Tonga was primed to blow. The previous day, a landslide had occurred on its ash-covered plateau, cutting the island in two and causing seawater to seep into the underlying magma conduit. This water was subsequently heated by the adjacent magma, causing it to flash to steam. Since steam takes up a larger space than the same volume of water, it caused an immense amount of pressure to build. Then, at 4:28 p.m. local time, the volcano catastrophically exploded in what was equivalent in energy to a 6-megaton blast of TNT. What had just occurred was the single largest volcanic eruption on the planet since 2011. Since it is now a month later, us scientists know a bit more about the eruption which occurred that day, which at first presented a number of unresolved questions. For example, we initially believed that the eruption plume only reached 35 kilometers or 115,000 feet in height. However, NASA later released a statement which showed that the eruption column had reached even further to an impressive height of 58 kilometers or 190,000 feet in height, which is more than halfway into space. This means that the eruption plume surpassed a theoretical limit of 50 kilometers in height, which no prior eruption column had done, passing into the mesosphere. Typically, the lower boundary of this atmospheric layer largely kills any upward mobility a plume has, causing it to disperse and maxing out the cloud's height. Thus, it was quite a surprise to see the plume temporarily reach a height of 58 kilometers, as this even surpasses the plume height of the last Toba supereruption. You heard that correctly. The eruption column was taller than the one produced by a supervolcano. So, why was this plume height able to rise into the mesosphere, defying all expectations? The answer to this involves several factors. First, the atmosphere is not distributed evenly around the planet, as at the poles it is thinnest and at the equator the atmosphere is thickest. Since the eruption occurred at 20 degrees south, it had the capability to travel beyond 50 kilometers in height. The second reason involves the depth which the explosion occurred at. If this same explosion had occurred instead on land, say high in the Andes mountain range, it would have involved far less water and only created a 30-kilometer high eruption plume. Or, if the explosion had occurred any deeper in the water, the seawater pressure would have reduced the size of the explosion. Thus, the eruption occurred in the perfect location and perfect depth, which was amplified in size by surrounding seawater. Third, the explosion began at depth and cascaded upwards in a straight vertical line, being funneled upwards by the adjacent magma conduit. Since the eruption occurred, more thorough analysis has been made of Hunga Tonga's older eruptions. New analysis shows that the volcano produced similar major explosive eruptions, which potentially formed calderas in both 200 and 1100 AD. The major eruption which occurred in 2022 seemingly follows this 900-year-long pattern, which in each case culminated in a single or series of VEI 4 to 5 eruptions. Speaking of calderas, it is quite possible that the caldera deepened during Hunga Tonga's eruption. Looking at its two remaining islands, satellite data suggests that they are uniformly 10 meters shorter than they were before. This amount of subsidence would perfectly align with expected values based on half a cubic kilometer of magma being ejected that day and the caldera's total area. However, these figures are potentially misleading. It is possible that the entire caldera rim partially slid to the south, giving off the appearance of subsidence occurring. Or, the explosion may have been more uneven than we first thought, conveniently blowing off the top 10 meters of the islands while leaving the rest intact. As for the still ongoing earthquakes adjacent to Hunga Tonga, these have been confirmed as caused by magma refilling its underlying magma chamber, which was partially emptied by January's eruption. While this could culminate in another powerful explosion, the refilling process is likely to take several years to decades, so another imminent eruption seems unlikely. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Diane Kovacs, for supporting this channel.